Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel My Time My Teacher. In this video I will tell you how to write a formal letter. Formal letter is the letter which is written to the editor of the newspaper or to the office bearers, those who are the officers like the police commissioner, income tax officer and so on. The people, those who are officers, those who have the responsibility, those who are dealing with some departments, there we write the formal letter to them. So here in this video, I will tell you how to write a formal letter, right? There, mainly I will focus on the letter to the editor, but I will also tell you how to make the changes if you are writing to somebody else. To begin with, I want to tell you the word limit of letter to the editor or the formal letter is 120 to 150 words. So we will think about the higher word limit, 150 words. You will not go according to the lower word limit, that is 120, because if you'll plan for 120 words, we will not be able to reach to that, we'll be there only. But if you are planning for 150 words, then easily we can reach to 130 words. So we will go according to 150 words. Planning of that and how to enhance the data, that also I will tell you. Right, so begin with the format of the letter. To start with, so first of all, we write our own address. This is the address of the person who is writing the letter. The sender's address, house number 123 XYZ Colony, New Delhi 40. This is the address. It is better to finish the address of the sender in three lines only. The first line, that is reserved for your house number, flat number, building name, street number, etc. The second line, that is reserved for your colony or the nearby. If you want to give some kind of landmark, that also you can give in the second line. But third line, that is only reserved for the city where you are living along with the pin code. Nothing else comes there. After that, leave a line, then write the date. I have written here 15 December 2020, 21, 25, whatever the year is. You can just write the date and the year. It is better to write the date in digits, like 15th I have written. Then the month in words, after that year again. Otherwise you need the separator if you are using only digits. Separator is required, but I will suggest you it is better to write in this format, not using the separators. After this, leave a line once again, and then as I told you, I'm just going according to the letter to the editor. First of all, we are writing the editor, the T capital, editor E capital, right? This is the post. We are putting the Times of India, the newspaper's name. Again, we are putting the before that because that is the article. We need to put the before the name of the newspaper. The T capital, Times T capital, India I capital. This is the address of the office, 32 Bahadur Shah Zafar Mark, New Delhi, and pin code, right? That is okay. But imagine if you are not writing this, you are writing to the police commissioner or to the MCD commissioner, then you can write here the commissioner, Municipal Corporation of Delhi, the address of the office, New Delhi, this and this. If it is police commissioner, the commissioner, Delhi Police, address of the office, New Delhi, this is the pin code, right? You can change it accordingly. Leave a line after that, then the salutation comes, sir and ma'am. Sir slash ma'am, that is the most formal way. In place of writing respected sir, respected ma'am, it is better to write sir and ma'am only, because we don't know who the person is, whether that is a male or a female, so it goes with both. After that, leave a line and write the subject. Subject dash 6 to 10 words. It is better to write the subject, the topic that is already given to you in the question. So use 6 to 10 words. Don't copy as it is from there as given in the question. Try to modify that in an attractive way, because this is the line, this is the subject which is going to like play a very important role in the motive of writing a letter, because the person to whom you are writing, that is getting thousands of letters every day, but he does not read it all, right? So if your subject, your title is very catchy, then the person will surely read further. Otherwise, he will drop the letter in the dustbin. So plan it accordingly, think about it and make it very creative, right? That is the most important role which it plays in the letter writing. Here I also want to tell you that the new format is there where we write the date after that. First of all, our own address, then the address of the person to whom we are sending, then we write date. You can use that also. That is also fine. Regarding the salutation and the subject, like in few teachers they tell, and few books also you will find that salutation is given later than the subject. Right? First of all, subject is given, then the salutation is given. That is not an issue, because I personally feel that it is better to write it here before the subject, because the person to whom we are sending is surely going to read the subject. Whether he is reading the content or not, that is another issue, but surely he is going to read subject, so he should be saluted before that. So we should respect the person before he is going to read our subject. If he has read subject and after that he is planning not to read the letter further, then our salutation is useless if you are writing later than this. So this is the idea behind this, that I usually prefer to write it before the subject, right? This is about it. Hope till now it is clear to all. Now let's come to para first. So in the first para, we introduce ourselves. We introduce our motive, why we are writing the letter to the person. That is to be done in the first para. Let's come now in the first para. If you are writing to the editor, then the language remains same that I have written here, I will tell you. But if you are writing it to some other officer, then you need to change it, right? For example, for the editor, I have written here, through the esteemed column of your widely circulated newspaper, comma, I would like to draw the kind attention of general public as well as the concerned authorities towards. After that, I have left it blank. This is basically the topic which you have written in the subject or which is given in the question that you will write here. Right? So it will be approx 30-35 words. The first para, it needs to be between 30-40 words, right? Keep in mind in that. After that, leave a line, come to para 2. Para 2 is the main content, main part of the letter, is the biggest para, which needs to be minimum 60-80 words. And there what we write the content. Everything about our problem, about our topic, about the subject, we need to write here in this second para. Starting from how the problem is started, how the people are suffering nowadays, why it is important to give notice of this problem preferably than others, why it is important, if it is not to be met with the solutions, then what will happen, that all things come in para number 2. After this, leave a line and come to para 3. Para 3 is again 20-30 words, and that is the solution and suggestions. What do you think can be the right solution of this problem that you are going to suggest here? Or if you have any other solution, any other suggestion, that also you can give here. It will be 20-30 words around. After that, leave a line and thanking you, yours truly. After that, put your signature, your full name in capital and bracket, and then your designation if you have any. If you are writing for the social purpose, you can write a concerned citizen, right? This is about the letter to the editor. If you will follow this, I'm sure you will be able to meet the word limit of 150 words, and you will also be able to get good marks out of it. Keep in mind, do not forget the format, because the format is the thing out of which the examiner is going to examine you whether you know how to write a letter or not. If your format is correct, it means the teacher will be able to understand that you have the knowledge of writing the letter so that you can get good marks. So always, first of all, pay your attention to the format, then think about the content, right? Content is also important, but first of all, the format. Hope it will help you practice a few letters, and then you will be able to understand that whether you can write the up to the word limit or it is less. If it is less, keep on practicing. I'm sure you will be able to write a good letter. Hope this video will help you to understand. Thank you very much.